No, I'm not a nurse. I'm a candy striper. Yeah, just a volunteer. You know, I'm actually not supposed to be even talking to patients. I can't resist it, though. I'm in school to be a doctor right now. So any chance I get, I like to come and say hi to patients and do a little practice of my skills. And I've been here all day and I noticed that they're not really checking up on you that often. I know it's never pleasant to just be in the hospital all day. You don't even have a TV. Sometimes doctors, they can be so short, I guess I would say. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, they just make sure you're not dead and then move on. So patients like you, who may not be getting as much attention as they need. Official doctor or nurse, but like I said, I'm in school to be one. Getting close to graduation, so I gotta practice as much as possible before I start my residency. Let me look at your chart. Just wanna see that everything is going okay with you and make sure that there isn't anything we need to check or so on, you know. Okay, let me take a look. Experiencing any pain right now? Yeah, it says you have a bit of an ear infection. Okay. Yeah, looks like the nurse didn't give you your drops today yet. She was supposed to come in here earlier and give you your medicine for your ears. Like I said, I know they weren't coming in here. I've been watching your room all day, and I sort of noticed that they weren't. Hospitals are so busy. I can't blame them too much, but aren't you glad I'm here? Don't worry, I know what I'm doing. Yeah. We practice on fake, I won't tell you the details, okay? Alright, so let me do that for you right now. I can definitely see her in a little bit of pain. Definitely a little bit of redness and infection. The nurse really shouldn't have skipped out on your chops this time. It's not good. You really need your chops at the right time. Thank you. feel okay. You are. You're right here. It feels okay. Do you feel any pressure? Type of build-up sensation? Any more pain in this ear? Your right ear. It's about the same. Okay. Okay. So now let me do your left ear. Same question for your left ear. Do you feel any pressure? Okay. Any more pain? Okay. The same. Good. Okay. So it looks like the medicine is nicely applied. It's going to go deep into your ear. And begin to sort of fight the infection. Okay. Yes, it also starts to clear out some of that earwax. When your ear is infected, it actually produces more earwax. Yeah. Just like when you're having a cold, you get congested in your nose. The same thing happens. Yeah, and you notice even more nose congestion now. Yes, it's normal with the ear infection. It's all connected through the sinuses. Mm-hmm. So, I'm going to take a clean Q-tip and clean out around the outside of the ear. Yeah. So, there's a little bit still of earwax. Moisture on the outside of the ear from the medicine. Just going to gently clear out that area and it'll feel a little more comfortable for you, okay? So, let's do that. Just going to gently clear, gently. is in the disposal. Okay. There we go. Now your ears are properly medicated. Good. I'm going to put a note of this on your chart. That way they don't give you a double dose of medicine. I don't really know what initials to put. I'll put BW. All right. Okay. Now, if you don't mind, I would like to take your vitals. It's actually something I would like to practice. I've only done it a couple times on a live patient, and it's always nice to practice, right? Okay. Yeah, I'm just going to do your basic vitals and check that your other general health is doing okay. This is a sanitary tongue depressor. It comes in that paper casing, which keeps it sanitary. And now, I would like you to open up your mouth. And I'm going to put this on your tongue and push it down very slightly. This will help me get a peek at the back of your throat. I will also instruct you to say ah. That way I can see your uvula. Yeah. I'd like to see that it vibrates and also that it's not terribly swollen. Okay. Fantastic. So, say ah. Good. Very good, you did perfectly. Put this in a bit. Yep, you guessed it. Now I'm going to take your blood pressure. This is a blood pressure cuff. It's going to go around your top of your bicep here. And I'm going to squeeze this bulb. And it's going to put a little pressure on your arm. And from this, I'm able to see what your blood pressure is. Okay. So, if you would please hold out your arm just a little bit. Okay. I'm going to try to make it as comfortable as possible. Don't want to be too tight or too close. Time. Perfect. I'm going to hold my finger on your pulse. Okay, your blood pressure is normal. It's a good thing. And your pulse seems to be normal as well. So let me take this off. There we go. You know, I didn't listen with the stethoscope. You see, I'm still learning. Okay. Now, I would like to check your eyes. They look a little bit tired. Have you been sleeping okay? Yeah, hospitals never sleep themselves. Seems like there's always some type of hustle and bustle going on. Yeah, I totally understand. At least it's pretty quiet right now, right? Yeah. Okay. So, just going to look inside your eyes. Make sure everything's okay. You don't have to look at anything. I just ask that you don't look directly at this light, okay? It's very bright and it's not good to stare directly at bright things. It can actually be damaging to the eyes, okay? you want, you can look at me, you can look at my chin, and just focus on that. You don't need to focus so intently, just a nice soft gaze is gonna be okay. Nice soft gaze. You're doing so perfectly. Did so well. I did notice that your pupils were a little bit slow to dilate. You could be just tired though. You seem very sleepy. You can fall asleep at any time, you know that, right? Yeah, if you want to close your eyes. Breathing. guess they didn't really notice. I detect a little bit of an issue with your breathing, which is a little bit of a symptom of pneumonia. It doesn't feel very serious. But it's so common in hospitals for patients to get pneumonia. So, I'm going to write it on your chart. And hopefully whoever comes in next can do something proper about it, because I actually can't do anything about it personally. But if they nip it in the bud right away, you should be okay, right? Yes, all I heard was a bit of congestion in there. It's a pretty clear sounding congestion. Yeah. Usually at these hospitals, they just have you hooked up to machines, and they don't, sometimes they miss these things, you know. So, let me write this down, okay? The next doctor who comes in here, I'm sure they're going to see this, and they can immediately start you on some medicine, okay? Alright. Don't worry. No. Stop. You're okay. You're gonna be fine, alright? Don't worry. You're here in the right place. There's people around you who want to take care of you. Like me. Okay? How are we doing tonight? Okay. Alright, let me take a look at your chart. Looks like somebody gave you your ear medicine. Good. Yeah, looks good. Things are starting to heal up, I can already tell. Yeah, you're doing perfectly fine. Okay, let me take a look here. BW is. And BW gave you drops as well. Who was that? A nurse? I don't have any nurses with the initials BW. Okay, maybe it was somebody else. Alright. So she says She heard symptoms of pneumonia. Okay. Well, let's take a look. I'll take a look at your eyes and listen to your chest, and we'll see if there's pneumonia there. I don't think so. I mean, it's very common in hospitals, but it's we haven't really heard it from you yet, and we obviously checked you earlier today and didn't hear it, so we'll just check anyway. Might as well, right? I'm not looking in your eyes. And just, yeah, please just focus right here on my chin. Yeah, your eyes are a little bit slow to dilate. Have you been sleeping okay? Yeah, it's a hospital. What do you expect? Okay. Now, let's take a listen, see if we hear any pneumonia. Breathe normally for me. Okay, I'm gonna try to breathe deeply now. That's it. You're behind you now. Keep breathing deeply. She was right. I did hear something in there. Congestion. And that's usually the sign that pneumonia is going to be starting to develop. So. Alright. Whoever was caught it very early. So we can nip it in the bud right now and you'll be fine, okay? Alright. Let me get you hooked up to the oxygen. This is just gonna go right into your nostrils. There we go, yeah. Just going to hook this up here. There we go, should be good. And I'm going to start you right off on a antibiotic. Yes, it's an antibiotic shot. I'm just gonna real quick, don't even have to look. Okay. Yep, right into your IV on your arm here. Alright, heavy is actually empty. That should have been changed earlier. Alright, you know what? I will get the nurse to come in here very soon with the new IV. She should be in here within the half an hour to change that, okay? Alright, so starting you on an antibiotic. And we have okay, perfect. You'll be okay, don't worry. Like I said, we got this. Very quickly, very fast. And I'm going to tell my head nurse to come in here very soon and make sure you're all settled with a new IV. And try to get some sleep, okay? And rest is very, very important right now. Close one. Yeah, I heard everything she said. I'm so glad she caught on right away. I know you have to have an oxygen. It's okay, it's only gonna help. Don't worry. Like I said, it didn't sound that bad to me. I didn't notice it, so I'm sure she heard it right away too. Yeah. Okay. Oh, you're so tired. Well, I think I know something that might help you fall asleep. At least probably bore you to death. Sorry, not to death. See, I do not know my bedside manner yet, obviously. How about this? I know something that'll bore you to sleep. Yeah. I'm going to practice a little bit of my anatomy. Just the face. Is that okay?